So welcome you all for tomorrow online classes. We completed the chapter oscillations. The last chapter which is left for us to discuss in objective part is units and dimension. So that is the first chapter, but we used to discuss that chapter at the end. Okay, so today we'll discuss concepts. The next class we'll start numericals. In this units and the dimensions. Okay now, so what is the meaning of physical quantity? Let me know some basic definitions. Physical quantity, any quantity which can be measurable. The measurable quantity is called as physical quantity. So physical quantities are classified into two types. They are fundamental physical quantity, and another one is derived physical quantity. Actually, some basics already studied in subject 2. But long days back, so that's why I want to recall one thing. So those quantities which does not depends upon any other are called as fundamental physical quantities. Physical quantity, when you can call physical quantity which can be measurable, then only it is called as physical quantity. Which does not depends upon any other is called as fundamental physical quantity. Whereas which is derived from the fundamental, so that is called as derived physical quantity. Those physical quantities which depends upon fundamental physical qualities are called as derived physical quantities. The examples for the fundamental physical qualities are mass, length, time, so etc. Whereas the examples for the derived physical qualities are like remaining, like velocity, even speed or force and acceleration, like etc. These are the examples for derived physical quantity. Okay, now so fundamental and derived physical quantity. After knowing that, what is the meaning of measurement? Actually, the chapter name is units and measurements. What is the meaning of measurement? Measurement is the process of comparing. It is the process of comparing. So comparing or comparison of unknown physical quantity with a standard of known physical quantity. Are you getting that? In measurement, what we will do? We will compare. Compare with what? So we will compare the unknown physical quantity with a known standard physical quantity of same type. It should be of same type. You should remember this, that a known standard physical quantity should be of same type. For example, a meter scale given to you. I told you measure this room length. Then, so meter scale is the standard known physical quantity. Here the room length is unknown standard physical quantity. You will measure. So 30 times of, 40 times of, 50 times of, so 30 meters of, 40 meters of, like that. What does it mean? You are comparing with a unknown physical quantity with a standard known physical quantity of same type. So that is called as measurement. This unknown standard physical quantity of same type is one name is there, that is called as what? Unit. So what is unit? Unit is a standard known physical quantity. Physical quantity which is used to measure unknown physical quantity of same type. Understood? In order to measure so unknown physical quantity, you needed one standard known physical quantity. That standard known physical quantity should have some properties. It should be available, freely available, and it should be so invariable. Everywhere the value should be remain same. Such properties needed to possess by a standard standard physical quality. That standard physical quality which is easily available, which is easily convertible, and which is everywhere, whose value is constant, is known as that standard known physical quality called as what? Unit. So actually, the units of the fundamental qualities are called as fundamental units. The fundamental physical quality units are called as fundamental units. And so the units of the derived physical qualities are called as derived units. Derived units. And some of the derived units, for example, if I take fundamental units, mass unit is kilogram, whereas the length unit is meter. I will write full name. So kilogram. Kilogram is the unit of mass, meter is the unit of length, like time of second is the unit. If I take velocity, derived physical quality unit, so if I take velocity, velocity unit is given by so meter by second. If I take acceleration, acceleration units are given by so meter by second. So because these units are derived from the fundamental, that's why these are called as what are derived units. Some of the derived units will be given scientist name for their great ground contribution. So in order to recognize them and in order to remember them, so some of the derived physical qualities, never fundamental, derived physical quality units are given scientist name, like Newton, Joule. That units are there, that all will come under which units are derived units. Are you getting that? So fundamental units and derived units. Okay, so this is regarding fundamental physical quality and derived physical quality. Then after completion of this, so next point is regarding the unit systems. You know that now, so unit systems. How many unit systems are there? So mainly of three unit systems are there. So one is of FPS system, and other is of CPS system, and other is of MKS. So in this, in order to measure fundamental qualities like mass, length, and time. Okay now. So whereas mass is measured in, or length, I will write length, mass, and time. So in FPS system, length is measured in foots, whereas in CPS system, centimeters, whereas in MKS system, so that you know. Here what I will write, length units, mass units, and time units. So here it is of foot, we will call feet. So mass, that is in FPS system, mass is measured in pounds, time is measured in seconds, whereas here length is measured in centimeters. Centimeters, and mass is measured in grams, and time is measured in seconds. Time same ga. Here also the seconds. Then here so length is measured in meters, meters, and mass is measured in kilograms. That you know already, kilogram. Time is measured in seconds. But nowadays we are calling SI system. So what is the meaning of SI system? The system of international. What is the difference between the SI system and MKS system? SI system is the extended system for MKS, whereas in MKS there are only fundamental, three fundamental physical qualities are there. But in the SI system, so there are seven fundamental physical qualities are there. So fundamental physical quantity, physical quantity, and its SI unit, SI unit of that fundamental physical quality and its symbol. Okay na? So what about the seven fundamental physical qualities? So mass, second one is the length, and third one is the time. Mass, length, time. Fourth one is the electric current, electric current. So fifth one is the so luminous intensity. luminous intensity. So next one is the sixth one is the temperature. Temperature. Last one is the quantity of substance. Which one? Quantity of substance. So these are the seven fundamental physical qualities in which system? In SI system. So what is the major difference between SI system and the CDS system, MK system? In SI system there are only, in MK system there are only three fundamental physical qualities are there, whereas in SI system there are seven fundamental physical qualities are there. So what are the physical qualities fundamental, and the SI units are what, and the symbols are what? So let me see what they are. SI unit of mass is kilogram. Kilogram. But remember, when you write the symbol, you should not write the symbol as you wish. So it is accepted abbreviation only you need to follow. Generally kilogram ki. So length is measured in meters. So you cannot write meter symbol as centimeters, only m. So whereas the time unit is 1 by seconds. The symbol you need to write only s, not sec like that. Electric current unit is 1 by ampere. Ampere. So whenever you are writing the scientist name, there is a rule that is in this ampere. So symbol is capital. Luminous intensity, so that is of candela, which is given by CD, capital CD. And temperature, so when you are writing the scientist name, there is a rule, so Kelvin. But symbol is given by capital K. Quantity of substance, so that is mole. Here also mole. Along with these seven fundamental quantities, there are two supplementary physical qualities are there in the system, SI system. That two supplementary physical qualities are given by. So what are the supplementary physical quantities? Supplementary physical quantities. What are the two supplementary physical quantities? So one is of plane angle, whose SI unit is given by radian. Symbol is given by RAD. And one more is given by solid angle, whose SI unit is given by steradian. So that is given by steradian. Symbol is given by, so that is STRED. Okay, now so these are the two supplementary physical qualities in SI. Total together, seven fundamental physical qualities are there and two supplementary physical qualities are there in SI system. Okay, now the system of interaction. You know that importance of units in physics. It is very, very, very important term. So to convert the unit from one system to another system, you will get some numericals based on to how to convert one system of units to another system of units. Okay, now. So next one is, after completion of this, in this measurement term, so some important definitions. What is the meaning of accuracy? Accuracy means what? Now one person, I have given one scale. I told you, measure the length of the object. So what is accuracy of the measurement with tensors? How close the measure value from the true one? For example, one object is there, that object length is 4.52 centimeters, for example. A given scale, one person has calculated, given measured as 4.50 centimeters, and another person now, he has measured as 4.55 centimeters. Now two readings are there. Out of these two readings, which reading is very close to true reading? that is 4.50. That means, so L1 is more accurate compared with which one? L2. So what is accuracy of a measurement with tensors? Accuracy of a measurement with tensors, how close the measured value from the true one. That is called as what? Accuracy. Generally, accuracy of a measurement depends upon precision. So what is the meaning of precision? Precision will tell us, so up to what limit you can measure. So that is called as what? Precision. The limit of measurement is called as precision. For example, I given a scale to you. If I given a scale, so what they can measure? So in scale, you know that. So scale, that centimeter scale. So what about one line value? So one line value will be 1 mm. So LCM for least count for scale will be of 0.1. So that's why after decimal by using a scale you can measure only 1 decimal. So that is given by precision. So if you use a vernier caliper as screw gauge, you can measure. By using vernier calipers, so you can measure 4.5. Vernier caliper's least count value 0.01 cm. Whereas an equivalent screw gauge, so value you can measure 4.5. So 4.523, because least count of which one? Screw gauge, so will be of 0.01 mm. That's why, so out of these three readings, precision more for which one is third? Next to this, then this. So precision will tell us what, how close the, sir, up to what limit, so you can make measurement. When precision is more, your accuracy will be more. When precision is less, your accuracy will be less. So that is the major difference between what and what? Accuracy and the precision. Accuracy will tell you how close the measured value from the true value. Precision will tell you up to what limit you can measure the physical value. So after completing the precision and this, so what is the meaning of errors? Errors means what? So errors are nothing but errors will tell us regarding what? So the uncertainty. If you did any mistake in measurement, so obviously you will not get the correct reading. So the uncertainty in the measurement is called as error. Okay, now the uncertainty in the measurement is called as what? Error. So this error is mainly of two types. So that is given by systematic errors. And one more given by random errors. So what is the meaning of systematic errors? The errors which always occur, always in one direction. Such errors are called as systematic errors. Whereas the random errors which are not always in one direction. Not always in one direction. Such errors are called as random errors. So what are the reasons for the systematic error? Some example for systematic error. So the imperfections method in measurement of, in the measurement, personal error, observation error, so instrumental error. Because of the instrument, for example, instrument having some error is there. Instrument having some least count error is there. How many readings you take? That error will be always in one direction. Such error called as systematic error. So what are the sources for systematic error? So the imperfections in the experimental method. The second one is, so instrumental error and observation lacking. So these will come under some example for systematic error. Whereas the random errors which may not always occur in one direction. Such errors are called as what? Random errors. Just a definition you should know. So what is systematic error and what is random error? So after the systematic error and random error, how to calculate the error? Error calculation. Then we need to discuss combination of errors. Very, very, very important by units and dimension. Take any competitive exam, either for JE or midterm, compulsory one question they used to ask. But to answer this chapter question, you should have the idea regarding the all chapters. So that is the reason this chapter why we discuss at the end.
okay na? So measurement of errors, error measurement, measurement of errors. So now compulsory what to get the accurate value, we need to find out the error, then we need make some correction, then only we'll get the accurate value. So for that reason we need to measure the error. For this, so let me come to know some types of errors. So what is the meaning of absolute error? Absolute error. So absolute error is the, it is nothing but for example, I will take one example. So what is that is, one physical quality, I told you, one physical quality length L is some 4.2. I take a note by using one scale. So I have measured first time reading 4.3, the second time reading I got 4.4, and third time I got the reading 4.1. This is my true value and these are my measured values. So what is the meaning of absolute error? So absolute error is the, it is the difference between the measured value and the true value. So absolute error can be represented in the delta L. Delta L value will be equal to modulus of L1 minus L. Y modulus means this absolute error will always be equal. So delta L value, delta L1 value is equal to L1 minus L. Similarly delta L2 is the, so absolute error is the difference between the so measured value and the true value. Similarly third trial, delta L3 value 1 value, so L3 minus L. Understood? So what is absolute error? Absolute error is the difference between what and what. So it is the difference between the measured value and the true value. Absolute error will be always positive. It never be negative. Now three errors are there. Which one I needed to consider? Which is the correct error? So that is given by mean absolute error. So what is the meaning of mean absolute error? Mean absolute error. It is the arithmetic mean of absolute errors. So arithmetic mean of absolute errors means delta A bar. Or delta, so A bar, mean value na, will be equal to, or delta L bar will be equal to delta L1 plus delta L2 plus delta L3 plus so and so, so delta LN divided by N. How many mean absolute errors are there? How many absolute errors are there? That absolute errors arithmetic mean will give you mean absolute error. Now I want to calculate mean absolute error. So what I get delta L bar? Delta L bar here as per given data, delta L1 plus delta L2 plus delta L3 divided by how much of 3? Mean value, that is known enough. So that is, that will give you mean absolute error. So mean absolute error is the arithmetic mean of which errors? Absolute errors. Are you getting it? As per given data, you tell me delta L1 value given by, this is 4.2, 4.3, so this is of 0.1 absolute error. So next one now, second trial also what is 4.4, 4.2, so that is given by 0.2, and third trial of 4.1, 4.2, so that is given by 0.2. then what is the mean absolute error value given by? Mean absolute error is given by 0.1 plus 0.2 plus 0.1. but remember, so though here L3 value less than L, here L3 minus L, but because of the modulus, here value 4.1, modulus of 4.1 minus 4.2. So actually this is a modulus of minus 0.1, which is of 0.1. So 0.1 plus 0.2 plus 0.3 divided by 3. So what I get answer, 0.4 divided by 3. So this is the value of which one? Mean absolute error, delta L value. By knowing the mean absolute error, so then what can I write? The correction value given by, how can I correct? The correction is given by, so that is given by L plus or minus delta L1. So plus or minus which one? Delta L1. When it will be plus, when it will be minus, you will talk to. So whenever the measured value more than the true value, so then what happened? L minus. Whenever the measured value is less than the true value, so that is L plus. Correction may be positive, correction may be negative. So actually this is not correction. So now this is the, so करेक्ट मेजरमेंट वैल्यू, करेक्ट मेजर्ड वैल्यू, बिकॉज इन मेजर्ड वैल्यू सो यू कम टू सम एरर इज देयर, यू कैलकुलेटेड दैट एरर बाय मीन एब्सोल्यूट एरर, देन यू नीड टू मेक दैट करेक्शन, करेक्शन मे बी पॉजिटिव और नेगेटिव, सो बाय डूइंग करेक्शन यू कैन गेट द करेक्ट मेजर्ड वैल्यू, सो और ट्रू वैल्यू, सो ट्रू वैल्यू विल बी गिवन बाय व्हाट एल प्लस आर माइनस डेल्टा, बट रिमेंबर whenever if you don't know the true value, then what we can do is, so we will take the true value as a arithmetic mean of L1 plus L2 plus L3 divided by 3, which is 4.3 plus 4.4, 4.1 by 3. So what I get? 4.4.4. So that is our value. 3 plus 4, 7, 8. That is 12.8 divided by 3. So 12.8 divided by 3 value approximately 4.2. Whenever they not given true value, what to do? So take the arithmetic mean of observations. Why we need to repeat the experiment several times means in order to reduce the error percentage. Are you getting that? So this will give you, this is the method for calculating true value. Every time it is not completed, we don't know the true value. When we don't know the true value, this is the method for calculating the true value. Okay, now, so this is for absolute error and mean absolute error. After completion of the absolute error and mean absolute error, so next one is, what is the relative error? A relative error and a percentage error. So what is relative error? A relative error. So relative error is the ratio of mean absolute error to mean absolute error divided by true value, or mean absolute error divided by which one now? By the measured value, or what I will call it as, so that is measured value. So measured value divided by mean absolute error will give you this relative value. So relative error given by delta L bar by, if my measured value is n, so then mean absolute error by measured value will give you which one? Relative. If I want to calculate the percentage error, so percentage error is equal to relative error into 100. Relative error into 100. What is relative error in my given example? Delta L by L into 100. Delta L by L into 100. Okay, Nara? So that is the percentage error. The percentage error and relative. So this is regarding how can we measurement of errors. Okay, Nara? Next. After completion of the measurement of errors, here instead of measured value, you can also write the true value. So true value of measurement, delta L bar by L, percentage error is equal to delta L by L into 100. After completion of this measurement of errors, the next important point is, we will discuss regarding, so what is combination of errors? Combination of errors. We will get errors while addition and subtraction, multiplication and division and power. First during addition. So addition rule. Addition rule, subtraction rule, multiplication rule and division rule. So what are these rules? We will see. This is very important part, errors. Even for JEE mains also, based on your practical part, that measurement part, so compulsory they will ask one question. Okay, so in this, so what is addition rule? For example, Z is one physical quantity which can be obtained by adding A and B. Z is a physical quantity which is obtained by adding A and B. But there is error is there in measurement of A, and there is error is there in measurement of B. Then how can I calculate the error in the measurement of B? z. If delta a is the measurement of error in the measurement of a, then in place of a, what can I write? A plus or minus delta a. So if I want to get the correct value of a, so a plus or minus delta a, delta a is the mean absolute error in the measurement of a. Similarly, b plus or minus delta b. Whenever, if you want to express, so which one? Physical quality after measurement of error. So that measured value plus or minus error. So then what is the error in z will become z plus or minus delta b. So then tell me what can I write? Z plus or minus delta z will be equal to, so a plus b can I write a plus or minus delta a plus delta b. I taken plus or minus common. So z value is equal to a plus b. So a plus b plus or minus delta z will be equal to a plus b plus or minus delta a plus delta b, which will be cancelled. A plus b cancel, plus or minus plus or minus. So what I get? Delta z. Delta z value is equal to delta a plus delta b. What does it mean? When a physical quantity is the sum of two or more physical quantity, then the absolute error in the physical quantity will be equal to sum of absolute errors in the given physical quantity. Okay, now in the given physical quantity. For example, we'll take the example. So I will consider one rectangle of length value L, breadth value B. So what is the perimeter value given by 2 into L plus B? Total length. If there is an error in the measurement of L, that is delta L. If there is a measurement, there is an error in the measurement of B, that is delta B. So what is the error in the measurement of perimeter? That is given by delta B is equal to delta L plus delta B. Are they getting our? For example, this delta L value is 0.1, delta B value is 0.2. So what is the error in the measurement of perimeter given by 0.1 plus 0.2? So what is my answer? 0.2. Are you getting that? So what is this rule name is called as addition. What is the statement of this addition rule? Whenever a physical quantity is the sum of two or more, let it be more also. It is not compulsory only two. So two or more physical quantities, then whatever the relate, the absolute error in the physical quality will be equal to sum of absolute error in the given two physical quantities. The same rule for subtraction. So what is the subtraction rule? Subtraction rule. For example, if z is equal to a minus b, that time, so what is the error in the measurement of z I want to know? Z plus or minus delta z is equal to, here what I get? A plus or minus delta a minus b plus or minus delta b. Then what can I write? Z plus or minus delta z is equal to a minus b plus or minus delta a minus delta b. Sorry, delta a plus delta b. Z is equal to a minus b plus or minus delta z will be equal to a minus b plus or minus delta a plus delta b. Then what I get? A minus b cancel. So delta z is equal to delta a minus plus delta b. What does it mean? This rule and this rule both are same. Addition rule, subtraction rule same. So what is the subtraction rule? Whenever a physical quantity is the subtraction of two or more physical quantity, then also the absolute error in the physical quantity will be equal to sum of the absolute errors in the given two physical quantities. Though z is equal to a minus b, delta z is equal to delta a plus delta b. It is not delta a minus delta b. Are you getting that? So this is subtraction. Addition rule, subtraction rule is same. Multiplication rule, division rule same. So now we discuss for multiplication rule. So I will write instead of deriving this, now this time multiplication rule and division rule. So I will write directly. So rule number 3. What is this rule? Multiplication rule. multiplication rule. What is this multiplication rule? So for example, if z is equal to ab, a physical quantity, first I write multiplication of ab. A physical quantity is the product of two or more physical quantities. Then what can I write? Delta z by z. Delta z by z is called as, so relative error in z will be equal to delta a by a plus delta b by b. This one we can prove it, but derivation not necessary for you. So that's why I did it directly. So what is this rule tells us? Whenever a physical quantity is the product of two or more physical quantity, then the relative error in the physical quantity will be equal to sum of the relative error in the given physical quantities. For example, so area of a rectangle. Rectangle area formula L into B. If there is a error is there in L, the relative error in L is delta L by L. The relative error in B is delta B by B. Will be equal to how much of delta A by B. So this is one example. Okay, now for example, they given delta L by L. If they given delta L by L, the relative error in the length is 0.1 and the relative error in the breadth also 0.1. Then what is the relative error in the area will become 0.1 plus 0.1, which is 0.2. Understood? So this is for multiplication rule. So what is the multiplication rule? Understood? Similarly, by this multiplication rule, so we can also discuss one more division rule. Division rule. So what is this division rule? For suppose if z is equal to a by b, then also we can show delta z by z will be equal to delta a by a plus delta b by b. So what does it mean? When your physical quantity is the division of two or more physical quantities, then the relative error in z will be equal to sum of the relative errors in a and b. Are you getting that? Whenever delta z by z, z is equal to a by b, what can I write? Delta z by z will be equal to delta a by a plus delta b by b. Okay? So you take one example. So what is this example is? L by b you want to. Even this is also one example. After completion of the last one more root power, so together I will take one example. So what is the rule number 5? That is power rule. So what is this power rule? For suppose if z is equal to a power a, given physical quantity, so can be obtained by raising the power of a to the n. If z is equal to a power n, then we can write delta z by z will be equal to n into delta a. Then the relative error in z will be equal to n times the relative error in a. Are you getting that? So delta z by z bar is equal to n into delta a by a. This is power. Power rule understood? If z is equal to a power n, z is a physical quantity which can be obtained by raising the power of a to the n. Then delta z by z is called as relative error in z will be equal to n times the relative error in which one? E. This combination of rules are these all rules are very very important. When question frequently they will ask based on this rule. For example, I will take one example. So in this example, I will take the combination of both multiplication, division and power. For example, z is equal to so x power a into y power b by so r power c. For example, now what is the relative error in z? So that is given by delta z by z. First, can I apply the power rule? According to power rule, a into delta x by x. Next, these both are multiplied. Multiplied which rule? So I can apply multiplication rule plus b into delta y by b into delta y by. Can I apply the division rule? According to division rule, so then also what I get? C into delta r by b. Are you getting this example? In this example, first let us consider this is not only these two are. Z is equal to 8 into b. So what is now power rule? X power a. So x power a means what happened? A into delta x by x. If I apply the power rule for y power b, b into delta y by b. But these both are multiplication. The relative error in z will be equal to sum of the relative error in x and also y. Now let us consider this one. Now division. So first let me apply the power rule. Power rule of c into delta r by r. What is the power rule value? C into delta r by r. But so even z is equal to a by b. So that plus or minus a plus. This is one example for which rule of power. Okay, now? So these are the combination of errors. Understood until now? So we completed one part of this units and measurement. So next part we need to discuss regarding the dimensional analysis and significant figures. So in the next class we will discuss that dimensional analysis and significant figures. Then we will start the numericals exercise questions. Okay, now? Okay, so thank you.